Hi, everyone. Greetings, friends.
To Jim
and Dave.
Beer review.
Wonder Twin Powers. Activate.
I was thinking more like
shape of an IPA.
A form of double beer.
Oh, that's original.
Well, it's like, you know.
That'll look cool when I put the special effects in, by the way, and nothing happens.
That was going to be like the,
We'll work on that one. We'll do that bit again.
Johnny Sokol and his flying robot there.
Yeah. We did that reference last week, though.
I know.
Hey, Dave. Yes. What's on tap?
We have some beers from Great Lakes Brewing Company, and this is called Chill Wave Double IPA.
Sounds familiar. Did we do this one before?
No. It's a double Indian pale ale. Family status is the wild child. Release is in March. Hmm. Packaging is 4-pack. Or, I guess,
case?
Keg. 1/6 keg or 1/2 keg.
Well, there is a lot of stuff on the bottle here. It says, our Chillwave Double India Pale Ale pays tribute to the North Coast's unlikely surf bums, the occasional great waves on the Great Lakes, and the unshakable spirit of adventure that lives in all of us. That's inspiring. Now, it says, Great Lakes surfers work hard for their thrills. They wake before dawn, listening to the weather report, like school kids hoping for a snow day. If the waves are worthy, they ride. No matter the cold, no matter the season, no matter the frozen crystals gathering in their beards, or the wind whipping, while white-knuckle conditions that they must face. To these chill rust ball surf dudes,
It's all good.
Rust Belt surf dude, sorry. It's all good. Yeah, it sounds a little crazy, but we didn't craft our double IPAs for the faint of heart. Now, with a flash of mosaic hops and a kiss of honey malt, it is a rush in a bottle.
That was awesome.
Ride our chill wave. Yes, it disturbs me we could both kiss ourselves at the same time. Then go out and find your own chill wave. 9.4% ABV. Dun, dun, dun.
ABW. What's that?
Alcohol by volume.
Weight.
Weight. Oh, okay.
7.5. IBUs are 80. Gravity is 22.
Oh, look. They got a date on here. 6/03/15. It's
that's
still
good
fresh.
Up till that day.
Yeah. Good up
but it should be up past that because it's 9.4. Should be good for a year or two.
Well, it depends on the brewery, I suppose, and the kind of hops and blah, blah, blah.
They have, the style is distinctly American. The double IPA or Imperial IPA is thought to have originated in California. This fairly new style is heartier, hoppier version of the traditional IPA with a higher alcohol content, creating a very strong and flavorful drinking experience. Flavor, hop forward with a balanced blend of mosaic and nugget hops. Ingredients, malt. Harrington 2 base malt allows color and flavor from other specialty malts to come through and makes for very clean beer. Caramel 45. It's like Colt 45. But the contributes to amber color, provides complexity. This is cool, man. The malts are telling you what they do.
Nice.
Honey malt contributes sweetness. Hops. Mosaic. New U.S. hops provides floral, tropical, fruity, and earthy characteristics. Nugget. U.S. bittering hops provides floral, resiny aroma and flavor. Cascade. U.S. hop.
Pay attention to the test later.
Yes, this is very good.
It is good.
I want to copy and paste this or something. You know?
Well, I want to learn to brew more.
Pairs with smoked beef, brisket, grilled lamb, sharp and rich cheeses, and sweet desserts. Shelf life, 90 days.
That's weird, because I always thought IPAs were originally made to last the long voyage from England over to India.
How long does it take to get there?
In the old boats, I would think about 3 months.
Wow.
Are you sniffing without me? We didn't look at the color yet.
How dare you sniff?
Well, it is. It's pretty clear. You know, carbonation looks decent. Not a big head, but I didn't pour it too violently. Not sure where it is on the SRM. Ooh.
Wow.
Now that has.
Florally.
Does have a floral note.
Florally.
Piney.
Florally.
Definitely a little bit of pine. Let's citrusy, sure. It's got all the stuff you'd expect from it.
Florally.
Seems like a West Coast style.
West Coast.
Ready?
Yep.
I beat around the Cheers. Hot bush. Cheers.
A hot bush.
Whoa. That is an intense flavor.
Wow.
I can't tell what the mouthfeel was because my tongue was too busy going, blah, 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 like, what am I doing about it?
Wow.
Ooh. Try that one again.
Wow. You know what?
Trying to reset. I can't do it.
That tooth of mine just freaking messing me up, man.
You have a hole in your head is what you're saying.
I have a cavity back here, and every time I drink something cold, it goes, sure, pain!
Well, that's a pain.
But drinking beer seems to help it, or at least numb it.
That's not too bad.
I like it. I'd buy a whole case of this.
I think you're just in the mood to go buy a whole case. Right?
I am. I did buy a whole case. I'm going to buy another case. I don't know. I'm like in the beer mode. I'm like, buy more beer. A whole refrigerator full of beer and a half a case of beer isn't enough for me, plus another half a case and another full case in the other room.
Don't look for a kegerator. I'm building our own.
I need more beer.
Well, mouthfeel is tingling. Not super smooth, but you know, big flavor. It's not overly piney. I've had some that were super pine. This is more of a...
I really like
this. More of a floral. Definitely floral. I wouldn't say sweet, but it's not... For being, what was it, 80 IBUs, there is bitterness.
It tastes like it. Don't taste like it.
Yeah, it's well-balanced. No
bitterness.
Very well-balanced. This is one of the better...
Florally, piney floral.
Yeah, not overly piney, though.
What am I? What is this?
It's not as, like, say, as piney as, say, a Sierra Nevada hop, what was that called?
I really like this.
Yeah, it's good. I like it.
I give it an 8.5.
The finish is pretty clean.
I give it 8.5, by the way.
Wow.
I really like it.
I think that's the highest you ever gave it a double IPA.
I did, and I like it a lot. I should buy a case of this. I want to go buy a case of it now. Let's go in the car and go to a case of it now.
Yeah, I like it, too. I would buy this.
Mm.
I think I might like more as a variety pack.
No, what about a whole case of this?
Well, listen, if Mr. I Don't Like IPAs likes this, this is
amazing. I like IPAs better than I used to.
Yeah,
I'm growing on me. Yeah. You get the right kind of IPAs. And you know why? It's the doubleness. It's because it's my high alcohol content.
Dave likes his alcohol content.
Can't like the alcohol.
Absolutely. Well, this is it's a treat. The bitterness does tend to linger a little bit.
Oh no, it tastes, I'm no like no bitter.
No, I mean just I haven't had a sip in like a minute and I'm still a little something there. There's it lingers, I think, for me.
Good stuff. Good stuff.
But it is better balanced than a lot of them are, I think.
Good stuff.
So my number, I think I'll
8.5.
No, it's okay. I'm
Oh boy, here you go.
7.5.
Oh my god, really? What's wrong with you, Einstein? Yeah,
it's well balanced. It's just not 8.5 is.
You should be
not
ashamed of yourself.
Fantastic. Oh please.
Nice.
Will you save your tap for after the review is over? You're going right to your thing here. Pay attention. We're watching the camera.
I'm not.
Look at our audience as we're doing this.
I am. Look at me. Look at me now.
Now you're looking at each other. Just don't beat your chest, because then a grill will come and crack the screen.
No, we won't do the other part.
That's
on
Star Trek,
about.
Right? The ones here?
Yeah, but I was going to do the other part, too, but you don't do that. That's bad.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, we didn't know what we're talking about.
We are right alone.
Yeah. Not your father's root beer, you know. That's some good stuff, too.
Yes. We'll digress quickly.
Yes.
We didn't put out a beer review because technically I don't think it's a beer. It's still kind of
got
soda.
Alcohol, though.
But it had 5.9 or 5.7? 5.7.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't taste like any alcohol. It's like, this is dangerous.
Yes.
Because you can say, I'm just drinking soda. Next thing you know, you're like,
yeah. Or your kid could actually get and go, Dad, it's only root beer.
And don't leave that in your fridge when your kids are ill. I'll tell you what. But anyway, this is a very good, very well balanced Great Lakes. Great job. We appreciate it. I think it's very well balanced. If you like the double A style, I think this is one of the better ones in the style. Absolutely.
Yep. I like it.
And do you have anything else to add?
No, I really like it. I'm going to go get a case of it right now.
And this was not a guy who was ever an IPA guy. This kind of beer has converted him.
Yes. Now I'm converted like I did when I had Old Dominion candy. I really like Belgian triples now, too.
Well, there's all kinds of styles, and you like the strawberry wheat. Remember that? That
was pretty sweet. Yeah, yeah, but this is better.
Anyway, do the government warning. Can you read that?
According to the Surgeon General, women should not drink alcoholic beverages during pregnancy because of the risk of birth defects. Consumption of alcoholic beverages impairs your ability to drive NASCARs or operate machinery. I'm sorry, drive a car. And may cause health
problems. Yeah, if you're trying to drive more than one car at once, you're probably impaired.
NASCAR, you know, they go 200 miles an hour.
Yes, that would make sense to drink.
And not do please that. Call Dave at blah, 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 because he has a really good time with you. Anyway.
Okay, I think you missed a few there.
I did. No, it's all I said.
Don't drink too much, cause health problems. Hey, listen, if you're under 21, don't watch this nonsense either, by the way.
Watch us.
Don't drink and drive.
Watch us.
When you turn 21. But the reason we find little gems like this, Dave,
I'm telling them. You can have a good time and laugh and fun stuff and sing and joy and have a great time with
your friends. Boy, if you don't say the part, you don't remember it. You're just like, it was like stuff and stuff, and there was some more stuff there. And stuff and friends.
I'm a happy guy right now. I don't know. I'm having a
because
good time.
He's happy.
I'm happy. Yeah, there you go.
Dave, we're going on the visitor.
Hello, Puff. It's Puff the Beer Cat.
Puff,
come here, Puff. Here, Puff.
I think she was about to sit down and hit herself. I think we're going to run.
Come here, Puff.
Go ahead, can make it on the video. People love it when
Puff.
You have it.
Come on, Puff. Come on, Puff. Not just the tail. See,
they're like, there's no cat there.
There's a cat. I'm touching myself. See?
Yes.
Give me a Puff the Beer Cat. I have to pick you up then.
Puff. I can't pick you up. Do you want?
Treat. See, look what happened there. Huh?
See, treat.
See, we weren't making fun. There's a blue cat right there.
Yep. Hopefully I can color correct it once it gets uploaded to YouTube. And do a better job when it gets to the, I actually edit these things. But anyway, thank you very much for watching.
You guys,
we do appreciate. And hey, Dave.
What?
We want people to comment below if there's a beer they'd like us to try. If they have thoughts about this beer, give us a thumbs up, a thumbs down. Comment, subscribe to our channel, all the other, you know, usual YouTube stuff that, you know, people
talk about. Our blue cat.
Hopefully I'll color correct it by the time it gets posted. But we'll
I like
see.
A blue cat. It
doesn't seem to be that way.
It comes from Pandora. Or
Pandora. Cat. I like that. Anyway, wonk, 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 wonk. Diarrhea of the mouth. Sorry, people.
I'm having a good time.
We are
out of here. All right, 12 minutes. That was pretty long that time.
Yeah, well, you know, we're just not in the groove.
I'm in the groove.
See ya, buddy.
See ya.
Say bye, Dave.
Bye, Dave.